Students will discuss about thermal conductivity. Thermal conductivity, thermal is basically heat, thermo means heat, thermal is related to heat, conductivity means transfer, okay, like electrical conductivity. So resistivity and conductivity. Resistivity means is the property to resist, and conductivity is the property to allow the heat to flow through it. So basically thermal conductivity is how easily a substance can allow heat to transfer through it, to conduct heat through it. So we'll take a solid conductivity. So conductivity part takes place in solid. So we'll consider a solid. I suppose the rod. This is solid rod, say made up of iron. Now, what we are going to do is, we will heat one end of the rod, and see what happens to the other end of the rod. When you start heating it, the heat will transfer from this end to the other end of the rod. Now, then it's okay that it will move from one end to other end, but can we say that each part of the rod, each part of this, here or here, this point or this point or this point, can we say that each part of the rod has same temperature? The answer is not. Certainly not. All the points may not have same temperature, even if they are continuously heating it, but all of them will not never have the same temperature. Why this is so? Now, to understand this concept, we will first let me explain to you. We will we'll make holes on the rod, small holes like this, and insert thermometers. Here I'll make holes, small holes, and insert thermometers. To have better contact of thermometer with the rod, we'll also pour some mercury. So here there is a thermometer. So, and this is suppose a reading of thermometer. Okay, this thermometer is there. I'm not drawing the thermometer, I'm just reading the temperature of the thermometer. From this end A or M, say M to N of the rod has length L. This end, I maintain at some constant temperature. Say I maintain this to, I connect this to, this to some steam bath. Steam bath. This connector, this is connected to steam bath. That means this end will always have temperature equal to whatever is the temperature of the steam, maybe at 100 degree or maybe 200 degree, whatever is the temperature of the steam. Okay, steam can have different temperature, that also you must keep in mind. Okay, so whatever is the temperature that I'm putting here, so this end will get heated up first. And if I see the reading in the thermometer, you will see that the temperature of this and this thermometer, that means the molecule which is very near to the heat end, has higher temperature compared to the molecules which are lying farther apart. You will see here the temperature like this, little lower, similarly less. This way it will, you will see there is a decrease in temperature. You will see there is a decrease in temperature as you move away from the hot end towards the cold end. This I will call this is the hot end. This is a cold end, because this end is being heated and this is comparatively very large distance away from the source of heat. So it will be relatively cooler, as also shown by the temperature of the reading of the thermometer. Now, basically the heat that we are supplying is carried by one part of one atom to the next part, next atom, and they transfer the energy. Here the electrons are, the free electrons are responsible for conduction of heat current. Just like in electric current, the free electrons are responsible for electric current. So in thermal conductivity or heat current, the free electrons are also responsible for this. So therefore, those substances which are good conductor of heat are also good conductors of heat also. Okay, so good conductor of heat and good conductor of electricity. So now if we look at the mechanism involved, the mechanism is this heat is coming from this end towards this end. Okay, this will absorb the heat and it will also rise in temperature, because when you absorb heat, then only temperature will increase. Okay, so its temperature increases and it will absorb, and some part of it will also be lost due to radiations, and some part will also be transmitted to the neighboring particle. So whatever amount of heat it receives, it increases own temperature, it absorbs and keeps it itself, and some part is lost due to radiations, and some part is transmitted conducted to the next molecule here. Similarly, whatever heat that this molecule will get, this molecule will absorb heat and its temperature will rise as shown in the thermometer. Then it will transfer the remaining, some part will be lost during this process from here to here, heat transfer, some will be lost due to radiations. And here also from here to here, some will be lost in radiations. And some part is transmitted to the next molecule. So here also the same process, it will absorb heat, raises its temperature, transfer some part of heat to the next. If you move from this point towards the right end of the rod, you will see that each molecule is doing the same thing, that it absorbs heat, increases temperature, keeps some part of the heat, and rejects or transmits some part of the heat to the neighboring particle. So by this way, as we move from this end to the other end, the temperature will keep on decreasing, because initially it receives more heat, and the same amount of heat that the second molecule will not receive. So as we move away, the amount of heat received by each molecule will also decrease. So therefore, the temperature rise also will decrease. So there is a fall of temperature along the length of the rod. That is, you can see there is a fall of, as you can see the temperature reading in the thermometer is like this, is the most higher temperature, this is then followed by this, and then this is the least temperature. This is therefore is called as a cold end. So the graph is something like this. If you look at this, the graph will be something like this. So it is just is the nature, this is how this falls exponentially. If we take into consideration the radiation loss and so on, if there is no radiation loss is there, then this will be a straight line. If there is no radiation loss, then the graph would look like this. If there is no radiation loss, then this will be a straight line. It's a constant. This is the constant, the slope is constant, and that the slope will represent what that we will discuss. Okay, so without loss, the graph will look like this, is a straight line. So therefore, the slope is a constant. What does this slope indicate? What is there in this line and what is there in this line? This is the length. If I draw axis, this is your x-axis and this is your y-axis. This represents the length of the rod, and this represents the y, represents the temperature. So the temperature is higher than lower than lower. If you plot the graph, it will be a slope like this. This is where you will take a temperature in this line and length in this line. So it is a constant slope. So this dt by dx, if the slope here is dt by dx, that is called the temperature gradient. But this is not a straight line in practice, because of some loss that is occurring due to this, due to radiations in between the heat that transfers from here to here, there is some loss here. So there is this is a loss of heat due to radiations. Another thing we have to understand is, suppose this temperature is T1, this temperature is T2, this temperature is T3, and so on. The temperature falls this manner towards the other end. Now, there is a term involved that is called steady state. Now, if I continue to heat, if I continue to heat for long time, then the question arises whether the temperature of this will continue to increase, whether the temperature of all will remain same. The answer is no. When you continue to heat for a long time, this temperature of this will maintain a constant value. Similarly, this will also maintain a constant value. This will also maintain a constant value. This is this line that we are showing is the temperature when they remain constant for different portion of the rod. All will not have the same temperature. They will have different temperatures. Obviously, the portion which is nearer to the source of heat will have a higher temperature corresponding to the portion which is lying far. Now, why they have the same temperature, why they have a fixed temperature? If suppose this temperature is T1, if I further supply the heat, because this is continuously being supplied, then also there is no rise in temperature. So, and this also T2 or T3 or whatever they have already attended, they will not, that temperature will not go beyond that value. They have their fixed values, they will attain their fixed values. And that if this situation occurs, that the thermometer stops increasing or showing any change in the reading, then that state is called the steady state. Okay, in steady state, the temperature will not change. The temperature of each portion of the rod will remain same. That is steady state. That means it is saturated with the temperature. The temperature is not going to rise for each portion. Obviously, each portion will have different temperatures. Now, why this happens is that why this happens? Because if the temperature, then one thing we can surely say that during after steady state, the temperature is not rising means the object is not absorbing heat. If you do not absorb heat, your temperature will not rise. That means after a steady state is obtained, the heat that comes to this particle, that heat it will not absorb, it will just let it go, transmit or conduct the heat to the next particle. Similarly, this will also conduct to the other particle. So that from this point to this point, there might be some loss. Otherwise, the whatever heat that is flowing through this end is equally transmitted to the neighboring end, comes out. Nobody absorbs the heat. So during steady state, we must keep two things in mind. Steady state, temperature during steady state, temperature at a particular portion is constant. That means this portion, whatever is the temperature, that will remain same. Similarly, for this case, the temperature will remain same. And that means different portions also have different temperatures. Okay. So, we can write different portions have different temperatures, but each portion has the same temperature. Each portion, whatever is the portion here, that will have the same fixed temperature. Then next point we can write is that the heat is transferred from one point to one part of the rod to the another part of the rod, and there is a constant during the steady state, there is a constant fall of temperature along the length of the rod. How that heat is transferred from one end to another end? What are the factors on which the rate of flow of heat depends? The rate of flow of heat, that is the quantity of heat that is flowing through this end of the cross section of the rod to the other end of the cross section of the rod. The length of the rod I will take as L, or the cross section or the portion of the rod I under considerations I will call this dx. This is dx length. The temperature of this end and the temperature of that end, they will have the difference in temperature. I will call say d theta or dt. Then this dt by dx here, as you can see here, the dt by dx, there is a fall, this slope is negative, that means the temperature gradient is negative, that means there is a fall of temperature along the length. As you move from this end to the other end, the length is actually, the temperature is falling down. So therefore, it is negative temperature gradient. So the rate of flow of heat, that is the heat flowing per second, depends on the area cross section of this conductor. the length of this conductor or the temperature gradient that is maintained. So it depends upon these two factors that we will continue in our next video in the coefficient of thermal conductivity part. Okay, thank you.